Two super quick things before we get going with today's vlog. Don't forget to stick around to the end of the video. I make a fool of myself. Get ready. Could be worth the wait. Also, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button if you dig what you're seeing, and we have merch. The Practice Room and Two Bass Hit both have new merch. It's right below this video. Go check it out. Now, let's talk about flight cases. So what is the best flight case for a bass guitar? I guess the quick and simple answer to that question is that there is no best. It's gonna come down to a lot of personal preference, what your needs are, where you're traveling, how far you're traveling, what mode of transport you're using. So in this video, I'm gonna give you as many tips as I possibly can based on personal experience, based on cases in my collection and gear that I have used over the past 20 years of traveling the world as a working bass player. Now, why do I feel compelled to make this video right now? Well, it's very simple. I'm getting really, really sick of having the wrong case. So right now, a spoiler alert, you will get to the end of this video without knowing what case I actually use currently. There are lots of options. You're about to see a ton of things I have that I just dragged out of the closet, but I'm not sure that any of them are actually the right case for what I need when I travel. Now, let's take a look at some of the things I've used over the past 20 years. I'll tell you why I use them and for the most part, why I don't use them anymore. First up, we have the biggest of the big, at least in my arsenal. This is a custom built flight case where the company, I believe, claimed you could drop it out of like a second story window and your instrument would be fine. I believe it was north of $1,000 or something like that to have it made originally, and it is by all accounts an amazing case, but it weighs an absolute ton. It's like carrying a Fender Rhodes on tour with you. It was cut out initially, the mold inside was cut out for my Federa, but as you can see, my Matteson fits beautifully in there. Might trim the foam if ever I would use it. And when would I use that? I would use that on a really big tour, probably where somebody else was doing the heavy lifting and where there was a huge budget for instrument freight, perhaps traveling a really long distance. But in terms of the kind of touring I do now, where I end up walking around cities and carrying my own gear and setting it up on the gig, that is an absolute no-no. And that case has, unfortunately, as much as I love it, has sat in storage for the most part since I kind of stopped doing big pop tours around 10 years ago. Next up, you've got the kind of delivery case, I want to call this one. It's the kind of case that your brand new instrument comes in. High quality, very sturdy, not something I would want to check my bass in on the plane on a regular basis because the bass isn't so tight inside. It's the really sturdy way of carrying an instrument around town, I would say. Or, like I said before, it's a kind of a delivery thing where you get your bass from the company, this one being from Federa. I have two of these. This bass is actually for sale right now. There's a link below in the description of this video if you are interested in taking a look at this bass and maybe even purchasing it. And this is the kind of case when I'm selling an instrument that I will ship the instrument in, because for a one-time shipping, I can pad that, make it completely safe, put it in a huge cardboard box and pad it again. And that's a really secure way of sending an instrument. Now we go kind of old school, and as you can see, this one is really falling apart. This is the original case for my Fender Music Master. It's pretty old, it's from the 70s, not unlike me, and as you can see, it's kind of falling apart in places. It's the old Fender, the old tweed case for that. I'm keeping this for nostalgic reasons only. I would never carry this bass around in this case. It's just a beautiful vintage looking piece that I'll always keep with that bass, trying to keep the originality of it as much as I can. Then we get into the SKB bass safes. Now, I've had 5 of these in the last 3 years. They are an amazing case, but the reason I've had 5 is because of this really cheap plastic clasp that holds it all together. I think the design is fantastic. I think the weight is fantastic. I think the fact that you can have a gig bag inside the hard case and have that element of being able to leave the hard case at the hotel and carry your bass very light in a gig bag to your gig is an amazing concept. But until SKB get this clasp thing together and make something a little more robust, it's gonna keep breaking. And after 5 of these things, I've spent a fortune. I think they're about $140 each. I'm 5 in and I'm kind of done with it, as much as I think the design, other than that clasp, is probably one of the best things out there on the market. The last time one of those went down was last month when I was in Boston. I literally had to ditch the case in the trash can because I didn't have anything to hold it all together, because the clasp had completely disintegrated, and all the zip ties that I keep in there for emergencies had also come out and disappeared. So I had to ditch it in a trash can in Boston Logan Airport and continue without it. So to their credit, I did light SKB up on Instagram and they did get in touch. They were very nice and they sent me this replacement case, one of their iSeries cases. And as you can see, super robust, really solid case. It looks almost like a rifle case. It does have a ton of foam inside, really high-end robust clasps. I just think anything you put in there is going to be super secure. The wheels look recessed enough to me that they're not going to get smashed when they're in flight or being checked, and the whole thing looks super, super robust. Having said that, I think it's a little bit on the chunky side for my needs, and it's not that far removed from the first huge flight case I just showed you in terms of what I would use it for. I think I would use it for big pop touring where I didn't have to personally carry that thing through the airport. I think if I had five or six bases that were all traveling and stacked on top of each other, that would be the way to go. So I'm not sure I'm actually gonna road test that, but thank you for SKB for reaching out after I kind of lit them up a little bit about the base safe on Instagram, and for sending me that. It's a really interesting case. I think it has its place in the collection. I just don't think it will make the cut in terms of my everyday touring on a small tour kind of case. And check it out, it's not all hard cases. I was very shocked when I saw this, but my good friend, the late, great Chuck Loeb, an amazing guitar player who I used to tour with, we were in Japan, I don't know, 6-7 years ago or so, and we both rocked up to the check-in counter flying home, and Chuck had an electric and a hollow body in a double gig bag, and he was checking that, and he told me he'd always check that and never ever had a problem. I personally probably wouldn't roll the dice like that. That was an unbelievable story, and one to this day I still can't believe it's true, but I was seeing it with my own eyes. But I do have quite the collection of gig bags. The Reunion Blues one that you see here is my very first one. It's a double. It's a great studio bag. If I have to take a bunch of basses to the studio, it's nice to be able to grab one bag and have two basses come in with you. So highly recommend the double Reunion Blues. I of course have my Matteson gig bags, super, super sturdy and really nicely padded. That's a really nice thick padding. Great front pockets, flying the Swedish flag. You know, I'm new to that because I'm new to Matteson. Really, really dig that as an in-town gig bag. It also fits very well in the SKB base safe. And then of course, this Levi's leather bag. I believe this is a Canadian company. I've had this bag for almost 20 years. And as you can see, it is really, really getting worn out, but still works perfectly. Nothing has ever punctured the leather. The base has never been damaged inside it. Really, the only issue for me are the straps that are wearing a little thin. Again, this bag fits in the SKB base safe very well, and it's just so sturdy. It's a huge peace of mind, I feel, when my base is in that bag. It is a little on the heavy side when you compare it to like this. When you compare it to, say, a Mayonnaise gig bag, again, to me, this is like the delivery kind of gig bag. This is the bag that just comes with the base, gets it from the store to your house. Might not necessarily be the bag that you carry the instrument around in, but perhaps more for storage or something. So the Levi's is way heavier. The Matteson, to me, is the great middle ground. It's the one that's kind of right in the middle that checks all the boxes. And now I know there are hundreds of other brands and designs, and you know, everyone's gonna say, well, what about the Groove Gear Blade? I have seen that, have never used it. I don't want to make a video where I talk about things that I haven't used and don't have experience with. So of course, let the comments and the questions rain down below this video, but please be aware that I know about all of these other ones. I just don't want to talk with authority about something that I know nothing about. And speaking of something that I know very little about, it's actually the thing that's on my radar right now that may replace everything in terms of my touring setup. And that is a recommendation from Tim Lefebvre, super just extreme bass player on all fronts, road warrior. You know, if Tim is telling you something about being on the road, you should probably keep your mouth shut and open your ears and listen closely, because he has maybe more experienced than anyone else I know, and he suggested the Reunion Blues Continental Voyager. So here we are at the end of 2019, Winter NAMM Show is coming up. I'm definitely going to stop by the Reunion Blues booth in a couple of weeks and check out that case. I believe it's a gig bag shaped case, but with some element of a hard shell in it. So something I can still check, and perhaps something I can even carry on if I really, really have to. Something that's checkable, but not as bulky as a flight case. So that is what's on my radar. I suggest you go out and really ask yourself what it is you need for your touring setup, or for how you feel about where your base is and how you treat it, whether you're okay with rolling the dice a little bit and gambling with checking it. It's not, to me, about the base getting broken so much. If your case is of high quality and well built enough, the base is not really going to get broken. It's more about the base getting rerouted somewhere else and you not having that instrument when you arrive in the next city. That is the biggest worry for me when it comes to traveling. It's not about the base getting broken. And as promised at the end of the video, oh boy, I screwed up. I really did. I was trying to be all, maybe you saw this on Instagram a couple of weeks ago. Okay, so I was trying to recreate that with the SKB, with the huge new case they sent me in the box. I thought it would be funny to send that down the stairs and get a couple of video angles with it. Now, what did I do? I sent it down the stairs with the camera on the tripod at the bottom. Of course, the thing is heavy. It's not light at all. It went sailing down the stairs across the floor. Really big mistake. Broke a camera lens and yeah, it beat the living crap out of my Canon. It's thankfully just the filter, the UV filter on it, but it's now bent and I can't get it off, so I gotta go to the camera store and check that out and have that removed. But this is how it is, making videos on YouTube. It's not all plain sailing. So thank you for checking out vlog number 364. 365 is up next. It's been so long since I started this thing. 365 was gonna be a big one, so we gotta figure out what that's gonna be. Maybe some suggestions below in the comments. Don't forget to check out the merch, the new podcast merch, Two Bass Hit and the Practice Room podcast. Both have their own merch right now. I'm psyched, we just put it together. I'm waiting for our hoodies and t-shirts and mugs and all that to show up so I can rock that on camera, but go check that out. Don't forget to sign the mailing list and leave comments and questions below. Vlog number 365 up next. It'd be good to do something big for that, so your suggestions are more than welcome. I'm gonna go fix some camera gear here, and hopefully this will be back up and running before vlog 365, and see you guys on the next one.